Hello friends, welcome to the Plant Science Forum. In this series of talk about the systematic studies and economic importance of some angiospermic plant families, today's topic of discussion is family Verbenaceae from Gamopetalae. Please note that some of the images shown in this video presentation are just representative of the characters concerned and not necessarily belongs to the family Verbenaceae. This is the systematic position for family Verbenaceae as per the Bentham-Hooker and Engler-Plantum system of classification. Unlike Engler-Plantum system of classification, Bentham and Hooker had proposed the series Bicarpellate as an intermediate taxon between subclass and order. Also, to understand the difference between both the system, just look at the different suffix used after the name of the taxon. Again, another difference is that both the system of classification had proposed different names for the subclass and order. There are many more differences in these two systems of classification, but here I have discussed only with respect to this slide for systematic position. The family Verbenaceae is distributed in tropical and subtropical regions of the world. In this image, you can understand which part of the world belongs to tropical region and subtropical region. Around the world, family Verbenaceae is represented by 99 genera and 3,151 species. In India, family Verbenaceae is represented by 21 genera and 125 species. Now, these are some of the common plants which belongs to the family Verbenaceae. You can correlate the image and the name given by a serial number. The first image belongs to Lantana camara, which is a very common weed. You might have seen it everywhere. Second is Clerodendron fragrans. Third is Clerodendron inermi. Fourth is Duranta repens. Fifth is Nyctanthus arborotrastis. Sixth is Vitex negundo. Seventh is Verbena bipinnatifida, and 8th is Tectona grandis. Some of these plants are very common and well known for everyone. Now let's discuss vegetative characters. The habit in family Verbenaceae is represented by herb, shrub and trees. As it is a dicotyledon plant, typically taproot system is present, and this taproot system is much branched. Stem is aerial, erect, quadrangular. Quadrangular means having four angles in the stem, and it's not generally circular but having four angles. Solid, that means not hollow and without air cavities. Spines is present on the stem, and stem is much branched. Leaves are exstipulate, means without stipule. Simple, means directly borne on the stem, and rarely compound. Opposite and whorled. Opposite means leaves are borne in opposite direction on every node on the stem, and whorled means having more leaves on the single node in the circular fashion. And they are petiolate, having petiole. Margin is entire in general, and venation is unicosted reticulate, and the shape of leaves is elliptical or obovate. Now let's see the first image. Glandularia pulchella shows the herb habit in family Verbenaceae. The second is Lantana camara, which shows shrub habit. And here Melia arborea shows a tree habit. Now here you can see a quadrangular stem. And also, if you look at the same image, here you can see the opposite phyllotaxy. If there are more leaves coming out of the same node in the circular fashion, then it is a whorled phyllotaxy. As next to it, this is the taproot system, which is typically present in dicotyledons. In another image, you can see stem with the spines. Now this image, stem with the spine, belongs to a Lantana camara. So you can see a representative character in this image. As we have discussed in previous slide, the leaf shape is generally elliptical and obovate. Obovate means an egg-shaped leaf with narrower end at the base and broader apex, whereas elliptical leaves means have a shape that looks like an ellipse, twice as long as broad, with the widest part of the leaf nearer to the middle, as you can see here. This is the elliptical leaf. Now again we have seen another character, that is leaves are extipulate. Extipulate means without stipule. So stipule is a leaf like small structure present at the base of petiole. So this is stipulate leaf, but in the family Verbenaceae leaves are extipulate, that is without stipule. Now let's discuss the floral characters for the family Verbenaceae. In this family, general inflorescence types are cymose or racemose, axillary panicle spike or dicagial spike. The flowers are bracteate, hermaphrodite, zygomorphic, pentamerous, hypogynous, and in Datura flowers are actinomorphic. Now let's discuss one by one each term. Cymose inflorescence means, in cymose the inflorescence axis is terminated by a older flower and younger flower are at the base, whereas in case of racemose inflorescence axis is indefinite and older flower is present at the base, whereas younger flower are at the apex. Now axillary panicle spike. Axillary means growing from the axis or axillary position. Now in this, panicle means an inflorescence which is much branched, as you can see here. This is the much branched inflorescence, and spike means flowers develop directly from the stem and are not borne on the pedicel, as you can see here. Now we have term axillary panicle spike means a combination of these two. Combination of these two means inflorescence which grow from the axillary position, which is much branched and the flowers are without pedicel. Another type of inflorescence which is evident in this family is dicagial cyme, or you can say another term is biparous cyme. Now this dicagial cyme means, in this type of inflorescence the peduncle bears a terminal flower, as you can see here. Peduncle bears a terminal flower and it stops growing. At the same time the peduncle produces two lateral younger flowers or two lateral branches, each of which terminates into a flower. So this is the biparous or dicagial cyme. The flowers are bracteate. As you can see, bract is a small leaf like structure which grows at the base of pedicel. So this family shows such a small leaf like structure, so they are bracteate. Hermaphrodite means having both the sexes, male and female, or you can say in general term a bisexual. Zygomorphic. Zygomorphic means, you can see here, if we divide the flower from its central position, or a flower can be divided into equal halves only from a single spleen passing through its center. Now this is the flower of Lantana camara, which can be divided into two equal halves only from a single plane which passes through the center. So they are zygomorphic flower. Now they are pentamerous, means having four whorls, and hypogynous. Hypogynous means all the floral whorls, they are growing from the below position of the ovary, that is sepals, androecium and petals. They are growing from below the ovary. But exceptionally in Duranta rebens the flowers are actinomorphic. That means, you can see here, the flowers can be divided into more than one equal halves by any plane passing through the center. यू कैन डिवाइड दिस फ्लावर इंटू टू इक्वल हाफ्स बाय एनी प्लेन विच पासिस थ्रू इट्स सेंटर. सो इट इज ए एक्टिनोमॉर्फिक फ्लावर. नाउ लेट्स कम टू कैलिक्स एंड करोला. कैलिक्स आर फाइव गैमोसेपेलस, दैट मीन्स सेपल्स आर फ्यूज, एंड लोट और टूथ. एस्टाविशन इज वाल्वेट. कैलिक्स इज परसिस्टेंट. कैलिक्स इज ब्लैडर लाइक एंड इट एनक्लोजेस अ फ्रूट. नाउ करोला दे आर ऑल्सो फाइव गैमोपेटेलस, दैट मीन्स करोला इज फ्यूज, ट्यूबुलर विथ स्प्रेडिंग लीव्स. इन लेंटेना इट इज ए बायलिप्ड करोला, दैट मीन्स 1+4 अरेंजमेंट एंड रेयरली कंपेन्युलेट शेप एंड द एस्टाविशन इज इम्ब्रिकेट. नाउ लेट डिस्कस. एज यू कैन सी गैमोसेपेलस, हियर यू कैन सी अ सेपल्स दे आर फ्यूज्ड, सो यू कैन से एज इट इज ए गैमोसेपेलस कंडीशंस. नाउ अनादर टर्म इज लोब्ड. हियर यू कैन सी अ लोब. जस्ट दीज आर द लोब्स और टूथ लाइक स्ट्रक्चर. एस्टाविशन इज वाल्वेट. इन द वाल्वेट, वाल्वेट मीन्स अ फ्लोरल वर्स. दे आर लाइंग साइड बाय साइड टू ईच अदर एंड विदाउट एनी ओवरलैप. सो दे आर वाल्वेट. दे आर परसिस्टेंट. दिस इज द इन्फ्लोरसेंस, मैच्योर्ड इन्फ्लोरसेंस ऑफ टेक्टोना ग्रैंडिस. यू कैन सी हियर दीज आर द सेपल्स विच आर स्टिल प्रेजेंट आफ्टर द मैच्योरिटी ऑल्सो. सो दे आर परसिस्टेंट. दे आर प्रेजेंट इन द फ्रूट ऑल्सो एंड इट इज ए ब्लैडर लाइक विच इनक्लोजेस अ फ्रूट. नाउ करोला, करोला इज ऑल्सो फाइव. दे आर गैमोपेटेलस, दैट मीन्स पेटल्स आर फ्यूज्ड. दिस इज द लैंटेना फ्लावर. यू कैन सी अ पेटल्स आर फ्यूज्ड, ट्यूबुलर विथ स्प्रेडिंग लीव्स. द करोला ट्यूब इज प्रेजेंट एज लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस एंड इट इज इट फॉर्म्स ए ट्यूब लाइक स्ट्रक्चर एंड देयर लीव्स आर प्रेजेंट एट द अपेक्स. लीम्स, लीम्स ऑफ द पेटल्स, दे आर प्रेजेंट एट द अपेक्स ऑफ द ट्यूब. नाउ इन लैंटेना इट इज ए बायलिप्ड, दैट मीन्स 1+4 अरेंजमेंट एंड रेयरली कंपेन्युलेट. कंपेन्युलेट इज ए बेल शेप्ड, that means they are rarely of such shape in the family Verbenaceae, and the estivation is imbricate. Imbricate means one floral member is completely inside whereas one floral member is completely outside and other three they are alternating to each other. So it is a imbricate estivation. Now as we have discussed here a bilipped corolla. Bilipped means it is a zygomorphic gamopetalous corolla in which petals are so fused together that they appear to be divided into separate leaves. Now androecium and gynoecium. Androecium, they are generally five, of which one is a staminode. Staminode means a sterile or non-viable stamen. They are didynamous, means present in two groups. Here you can see one group and another group. So they are didynamous. They are inserted. Inserted means the length of the filament of the stamen, it is so short that it doesn't come out of the corolla tube. So they are inserted within the corolla tube. You can see here the stamens, they are inserted within the corolla tube. This image doesn't belong to family Verbenaceae, but it is shown here as a representation of the character only. Now they are epipetalous, that means present on the petals, alternating with the corolla lobes. Diathecous means having two anther lobes. You can see here two anther lobes. Intros, intros means anther, they are facing toward the gynoecium. You can see here, and they dehisce by longitudinal section. Now in the gynoecium, gynoecium is two, it is syncarpous, that is fused. superior, you can see here, gynoecium is present above to other floral whorls, sepals, androecium and petals. So gynoecium is superior. It is usually bilocular, but during development a false septum may arise, because of which it forms a tetralocular ovary and the placentation is exile. Here you can see exile placentation. This image, which is of tomato, here you can see a exile placentation, but this tomato doesn't belong to family Verbenaceae. I have shown only for representation of the character. The fruits in this family are drupe, rarely capsule or berry, and non-endospermic seeds, means endosperm is absent, reserve food material is absent. The image shown here, it is a berry type of fruit which is present in family Verbenaceae. Now pollination is by butterfly and bees. Nectary is present at the base of ovary. So here you can see a different pollinators. Now floral formula. If the corolla is not bi-leaved, then the first floral formula applies, where the flower is bracteate, zygomorphic, bisexual, calyx is 5 and fused, so gamosepalous. Corolla is 5 and fused, so gamopetalous. Androecium, they are present in didynamous condition. Gynoecium is superior, they are 2 and fused, so syncarpous. In another condition, when corolla is bilipped, in such condition it is a bracteate, zygomorphic, bisexual. Sepals are 5, but 4 is another leaf and 1 is preserved. 1 looks like another leaf. So 4 plus 1 in bracket, fused. Petals are 5, fused, gamopetalous. Androecium are didynamous condition. Gynoecium is superior, 2 and fused. And this arch represent androecium is epipetalous, that is present on the petals. Now the diagnostic character for this family Verbenaceae is, the habit may be tree, shrub or herb. Stem is generally quadrangular. Leaves are simple or may be compound. They are ex-stipulate. Calyx is 2 or 4 to 6 partite. Epipetalous stamen. Shape of the corolla is zygomorphic. Stamens are didynamous. Nectar disc is present below the ovary. Fruits may be drupe or berry. Now these are some of the economic importance of the members which belongs to family Verbenaceae: Clerodendron indicum, Duranta repens and Tectona grandis. I hope you understood the topic. If you like the contents of the topic, please subscribe to the channel. Thank you.